Buying dowels is often a frustrating experience because when you buy the dowels, they're very rarely round and they're too big or too small and you really can't use them for joinery. And where do you get good dowels? You can mail order short ones, but it's just frustrating. So here's a method that I just used to make a whole bunch of dowels, and they're all within a few thous. So let me show you the method.
I start by cutting some square stock that is just a tiny bit larger than the dowels I want to make. Now I could probably use these sticks square, straight in my dowel making method, but I find it helps to round off the corners, so that's what I'll do next. Now the easiest way to cut the corners off of my sticks that are going to be dowels is to use a router table. And I could use a chamfer bit to cut the corners off to make it essentially octagonal, but a roundover bit works really well too. So I've got a quarter inch roundover bit in here, which would potentially cut dowels of a half inch diameter, but I want to cut 3/8 inch dowels. But this is actually just perfect because I don't want to cut away all the way into my dowel. I just want to cut the corner off, and if that corner is rounded, that's better than octagonal. So I set the height of that so that it doesn't cut away any part of a 3/8 inch rod, and I'm just using a shank of a drill to check it here. So I'm just cutting away the corners so I don't have to remove as much material for the next step. Now I want to make sure that when I cut these that my stick is always forced right against here. So I'm going to use a fingerboard to press it in from the side, and then I'm going to use another fingerboard from the top, and I'll just attach that with a C-clamp to press it down so that when I push my dowels or my future dowels through here, I'll make sure it's always in the corner. Each stick needs 4 passes through the router table, and I'm always using the next stick to push the previous stick, so I never have to get my fingers really close in there. And I'm just always reaching around, grabbing the last stick, and then pushing it through again at 90 degrees. So here's the dowel blanks. They look kind of almost like dowels already, but they're too large. And they're not entirely round, they're only with the corners rounded off. So next comes the magic part. So this jig works a lot like the old pencil sharpeners. So I've got a hole here that's large enough to accommodate the sticks that I've just cut. And I've got a chisel position here. And towards the back, there's a smaller hole that's 3/8, which is exactly the size dowel that I want. And then I cut it open with a table saw after I drilled the holes, so that I could position the chisel just where the edge of that smaller hole would be. And I put that chisel at an angle to help cut away the material so I could start from the larger radius and work its way down. And the chisel is just held on with a C-clamp. So let's give that a whir. So here's a batch of dowels that I've made. They've all got a bit of a spiral on them from how they went through the dowel maker, but let's check them for accuracy. So they're supposed to be 3/8 of an inch, which is 375 thou. So let's check this one, and it's 370. So 5 thou under here, 370, 5 thou under, 375, 374, 373, 373. So they're all within a few thou, and that's a lot more accurate than the dowels that you can buy at places like the Home Depot. And really, that's the main reason for making your own dowels. Dowels aren't very expensive to buy, but finding accurate ones is really hard.